What's up, guys? It's Ryantium here, and today we are back in Skyrim. That's right, you guys, and oh snap, is it gonna be an awesome freaking day. So guys, welcome back, and happy Sunday. So guys, today we're actually nowhere near any of the other holds, with the exception of Dawnstar, because we're actually all the way up here, up in the frozen north, taking a look at Lingui. So Lingui is not necessarily just a player home, but a player village. We've actually taken another look at, player home kind of mod thing, in one of the last sections and one of the last showcases that I did on Fleetford. Fleetford is another one of the player villages with a home inside of it. Now, Lingui is a frozen wasteland, basically, up here, but Lingui is a, it's kind of like a Nordic/Viking settlement, similar to that which you will find in Solstheim with the Skull. Now, it's basically a mock-up of the Skull village within Solstheim, which is pretty cool. Now, how exactly do you get here? Well, there's a few ways, and I gotta do a little bit of a disclaimer here at the beginning. So, in the mod description, it states, it's located on a small island north of Dawnstar. It's not small, that's for damn sure, but the fast travel system, they've implemented a new fast travel system, and what it is you can travel to and from Solitude, Windhelm, Dawnstar, and Winterhold by boat, but you first have to buy a key from the local merchant named Marada. It says he hangs out at his small hut most of the time. Now, I have yet to find Marada and his small hut, so I don't think I'll be able to show you that. So what you have to do is you gotta swim. And it is not a short swim either. And unfortunately, the only way to do that would be to not play with the Frostfall mod on, because if you notice, I had to go from there to here without a boat, without a horse. That, you know, if you're on a horse, it can't swim. I mean, you could take a dragon out here, but it's not like you can actually fly the dragon. But, you know, if you can invest in a water walking spell, that would be great. If you can invest in a water breathing spell, that would also be wonderful. But we're just going to go ahead and take a look at this. And, you know, for those of you that really want to use this, perhaps if you find Marada, let me know where he's at down there in the comment section. I'll pin your comment and we can take a look at it there. But without further ado, let's actually check this out, shall we? So let's go ahead and clear the weather just a little bit so we can see just how awesome this looks. And the settlement is indeed quite large, as you can see. So we have our gigantic, you know, longhouse right there, and that's actually not even the Great Hall. The Great Hall is towards the back. I think it's that hall right there too. But this is modeled very much so after, you know, a Viking settlement. Now, I love the fact that they've put it up on top of this gigantic glacier, because they're gonna be pretty safe up here, with the exception of dragons, you know. But I don't foresee dragons coming out here. But it seems the only way up is indeed that rickety wooden staircase. Now, over here, in fact, is the fast travel section that I was talking about before. You have, you've got Dawnstar, you've got Solitude, you've got Windhelm, and then you've got Winterhold. And each one of these is a teleporter, but it requires the key to Skyrim, and, well, there's no key. So unless it's in one of these barrels, I don't foresee that happening, but that is okay. But like I said, you guys, if you can find, I don't know why there's so much damn mead down here, if you find Marada, do please let me know. That way I can pin your comment down there in the comment section, and then everybody can use it just as they want to. But let's actually get into this, shall we? So enough of the floating around, let's get into this. So down here, there's a few things going on. We have this big boat right here with a couple NPCs on it. Lots and lots of stuff in here, and you can indeed just take everything. You're not going to steal it. It's kind of nice that you have access to all of this stuff without even having to steal it. A little bit of Shrine to Talos right there. And then down here, we actually have a shipment from the Imperial, the East Empire Trading Company. Hello there, Saskia. But we can actually come over here, and behind here, there's a chest, and it is filled to the brim with Imperial stuff. So if you ever wanted to use the Imperial stuff, you could absolutely just get yours there, which is pretty cool to see. Hello, Novabit. Good to see you, buddy. But enough dilly-dallying down by the harbor. Let's actually check this out. I love the giant lift that's lifting all the mead barrels up there. Looks like that's pretty much what they like to do out here, is just drink, because there's a lot of mead. But there are three treasures to be found on this island. So you'll have to do some looking around. You got some huskies over here, which is super cool to see, super adorable. All right, got the counterweight right there for the big lift right there. Kind of cool to see. But The village itself starts over here. Now, the player home itself is quite a modest player home, a fairly small player home, but nonetheless a player home. Now, this right here is the Lingui Mead Hall. This is where all that beer is going. I'm not going to go into all the buildings just because it would get a little bit tedious, because all they are the people's homes. But over here is your crafting section. It's kind of the town's crafting section. So you have not only the cooking pot, but you've also got a workbench and a blacksmith forge, as well as a wood chopping block, a smelter, and a grindstone. Now, I've yet to see the tanning rack, but I'm sure it's around here somewhere. And then this is Thora's house. Now, each of the homes is indeed named after one of the people that live in the town. Obviously, that makes sense. But let's see, is the tanning rack anywhere to be found? Yes, indeed, there it is. So there's your tanning rack right there. So the only thing that I have yet to see is nothing, actually, because we have the grindstone and then the workbench right there. But let's see, we also have Thora's house right there, another husky, hi big guy, and then we've also got Rodegard's house, and then over here we've also got Wilgard's house, and then next to the Great Hall, so we have the Great Hall right here, is your home. Now this is the player home. It's modest, it's small, just like I said, but when you're living out here, on the snow, on the ice, fishing, drinking beer, and working the day away, this is all you need. So the name of the house is indeed Snæfell. I believe it's a Nordic word, but I love this little entrance in here. The little campfire the little fireplace in the middle reminds me of Bree's home, kind of nice, and it's kind of cool. It kind of mimics Bree's home, honestly. But as we move through the little home, we can just go ahead and check out this nice little seating area. And like I said, in the mod description, it actually does say that there's no custom assets, which means this is all stuff that's been in Skyrim and been used throughout Skyrim. So it's a fairly vanilla with sprinkles home. So down here, we've got a nice big chest right here where you can store a lot of your stuff. It's a nice big drop-off chest. But over here, we have our enchanting table and our alchemy lab with a few assorted good stuff. Don't know why those would be there just out of nowhere, but, you know, to each their own. And then if we go ahead and come on up here, we can go ahead and check this out. Now, this is the bedroom area as well as just the loft, and I love that it's a loft. I think it's kind of nice. You know how much I love lofts if you've been watching me for a while. And then in here, we have the master bedroom. Now, the architecture of the actual home, I like it because it matches the same outside. One thing that I've said, excuse me, I'm sorry about my throat. One thing that I've actually noticed and picked up on with a lot of mods before is the architecture on the inside of homes isn't what it is on the outside, but this matches very well and it keeps the continuity with the home, which is really, really nice for me because I'm kind of a stickler for that. But nonetheless, this is your nice, modest, you know, small home. It's quaint. I like it. There's the, you know, the bare necessities that you could possibly need to survive out here. And this home is not for everyone. I will say that, because this is more so for the people that want to roleplay, get very deep into a roleplaying situation where you're more so roleplaying as someone who is a detachment from the Skull, or, you know, just a little town that you founded off the coast of Dawnstar in Skyrim. You know, you can really build a deep lore and a deep backstory for a character that's living in this little village. Now, the only reason I came into the Great Hall is to showcase just how beautiful it is and how much it mimics Dragon's Reach. And that's what I love about this, is how much it looks like Dragon's Reach. Now, there is a countess and a count of this city and of this town and of this settlement, which is really, really cool. And, you know, it's not a Viking longhouse, but it's certainly a longhouse, which is really, really cool to see. But overall, I think this home, like I said, is more so for the people that really want to get into roleplaying. Now, there, like I said, there are a few secrets, and in fact, I'll go ahead and show you where one of them is at. Over here, we have an archery target practice and then a statue to Talus over here. But if you come back behind the Great Hall into the backyard, and then you come down this way, if you jump down this way, or you come down over here and you start swimming, back behind your player home and the rest of the town, there's actually a crashed boat. There's two, in fact. And I'm trying to remember exactly where the location is at. I'm pretty sure it's over here. Yes, here it is. So if you come down behind all of the homes, one of the crashed boats, if you come underneath the water, you can actually check this out. And let's see. Cheat God, please. Thank you very much. You can actually check this out. There's a buried treasure underneath of the water inside of this first boat. So if we come down here, and then we come down here, in this second part, there's a big chest right here. Inside, is 1,500 gold. So we'll go ahead and take that just for shits and giggles. But guys, with that, I do believe that's everything that this mod has to offer. And I gotta say, as far as a village mod and as a town mod, this one kind of hits me in a good spot because I'm a big fan of Norse mythology and I'm a big fan of Vikings. So I think this fits it pretty damn well. So guys, I very much hope you enjoyed today's mod showcase, and I will see you in the next video.